Now we head toward Tule Springs. There are a number of different paths that you can take to get there. We choose to head south on Highway 169 North Shore Drive. This route passes through some gorgeous red sandstone areas and makes for a truly scenic journey.
Finding Tule Springs Fossil Beds National Monument isn't difficult. It's over 22,000 acres along the north edge of Las Vegas and up Highway 95. However, there is currently no road that enters the area, so you can't drive in. But the boundary is marked by these posts that explain that you're entering National Park Service land, so you can just step over and enter on foot wherever you find these.
Once we arrive, we meet Kathleen Springer and Jill DiStefano, who have found both scientific and cultural value in this area.
Hi, you guys.
Hi, how are you doing?
Thanks for meeting us out here today.
Yeah, no problem.
So what are we looking at?
Well, we're in Tule Springs Fossil Beds National Monument. This is an area where there are thousands of fossils embedded in these deposits here. So we're going to go and look at one of the fossil sites and look at some of the areas that were historic fossil localities.
We can actually see fossils that are still in some of the rock structure?
Well, let me put it this way. All of these deposits are fossiliferous. So they have the potential to have fossils in them. But we're going to take you to a place where there's a few of them. You'll be able to recognize what they look like. The fossils are protected here. So just regular folk are not, you know, allowed to have a souvenir in a national park unit.
Right. But we can go take a look.
Well,
let's go do it.
Yeah.
Kathleen is a geologist and paleontologist with the U.S. Geological Survey and has been exploring Tule Springs for years.
Kathleen, yeah. I've always wondered, how come this layer has all those like dark ridges and that's all nice and smooth?
Well, for one, this has a more silty clay component to it, and this is sandier. And what we're seeing here is a contact, so it's a geologic contact between two units. This one we call Member A of the Las Vegas formation. So we have member A, B, D, and E. And it ranges from older than 300,000 to about 155,000.
So what I notice is horizontally, there's a pretty definitive line. Was there an event there that caused this total change in the way that it
looks?
Yeah,
that's an awesome question. This is actually called a geologic contact. So member A deposited, and then there was some kind of an event. Basically, this is called an unconformity. So there's missing time here. Mm.
And do you find fossils throughout the various layers, or are they centered in one?
We do find them. So the whole formation is pretty fossiliferous. So we haven't found any mammoths in this stuff yet here in Tule Springs. We found little guys, little invertebrates like ostracods, but member B, lots of fossils. So and people look at it and go, but it's all white dirt. It looks all the same, but it's not. I swear it's not.
Tule Springs has only been a national monument since 2014, and Jill played a large role in making that happen. Before that, it was slated for commercial development, but when Jill attended a public meeting about it, she was moved to act.
The Bureau of Land Management told our community there were 438 fossil sites designated laying on the surface of mammoths and sloths, and we had camels here.
Oh my gosh.
We got together afterwards and thought, why would we not preserve it for our kids, for the future generations, and for this science education that's so important today?
We all get the benefit of Jill's hard work. Walking around here, it's odd to imagine this as a marshy wetland, and I really have to rely on my imagination to see mammoths and saber-tooths walking around.
So this is kind of this is basically a high-graded site. And there's fossils in this stuff too. So just the average person walking around here, you're not gonna know. You're just gonna walk and you're gonna enjoy.
Probably why it's still here.
You may notice something, but you keep looking and then you finally go, okay, I know what that is.
Look, yeah. She just found one right there.
Bone. Exactly, that's bone.
We'd bring the little tiny kids up here and I'd say, okay, now you've seen that. Do you see any bone? And they'd get so excited when they find something.
Bone.
Like that.
Yeah, that's right.
Yay!
As the sun begins to descend, the shadows lengthen and the scenery starts to change for the better. Even without the fossils, Tule Springs has its share of visual appeal. Thank you.
is one of the localities from the Tule Springs expedition in the early 1960s. There were a lot of fossils found here, and archaeology was found here. There's also this really cool kind of rock here called tufa. There was mammoth, horse, antelope. A giant bird called a teratorn was found here, wow. One of the largest flying birds of the Pleistocene. Looked just like that. So there's a couple pieces of bone eroding out of here. This is a very well-known locality. Lots of fossils came out of this place, but there's still bone coming out. And it's in this horizon that's about 20,000 years old.
And do you think there's more to be found?
Oh, yeah. Oh, so much more. You walk around and there's fossils coming out of the ground.
We're lucky we were able to come and see it.
Yeah.
It could have been your latest 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like a Slurpee as much as anybody, but yeah. Not that much.
I tell people that all the time, that the city of Las Vegas has been built on these types of deposits.
The sun is setting on Tule Springs, which is our cue to get back to town for the night. We've got a big day ahead of us tomorrow.